there, my name is Irene, and in this video I would like to show you how you can create a multi-level building in SketchUp. So let's get to it. Alright, so I'm going to continue working with this first level of a house model that I have been working in previous videos. Now, I'm going to be entirely honest with you. This would not be my favorite method to build a multi-story building. If you want to know why, you can refer to my assembly model video. I'm posting the link for it now. But basically, the idea is that if I'm working with a multi-level building and I am going to be working with other people, I'd rather split the model in parts and then assemble it somewhere else. But let's assume for a second that you have the most powerful computer in the market and it's just you working in this model. So there's no reason for you to split the model into parts. You just want to build a multi-story building. So, okay, that's fine. That's not a problem. So what we're going to do here is once we build our first level, basically what we're going to do is now we're going to start with the second level. So the process is going to be very similar to the way that we built the first level. We're just going to change the height. So what does that mean? Well, I'm going to start by importing my level 2 reference. So the same way that I have a reference for the level 1, I too have a reference for the level 2. So we're going to go file, and I'm going to go import, and I'm going to select my level 2, and I'm going to click import, I'm going to click close, and you can see that my model has been placed here. Now you can see that it is currently overlapping my level 1. That's fine, that's not a problem, because the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to move this new reference to where we actually need it to be, which is atop the ceiling of my level 1. Remember, this is, I call it the plenum, although that's not really the term for it. This is basically my slab between my level 1 and my level 2. So I'm going to select my level 2 reference. I'm going to go M for move, pick it up, use my arrow key to make sure that I can only move it vertically, and then I'm going to bring it here. That's it. It's as simple as that. Now, the other thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to change the nomenclature, my tags. Because the thing is that if you remember, I've been talking about this guy as the ceiling of my level 1. But the thing is that if you have multi-levels, technically speaking, it's not really a ceiling. It's just a slab because it's the space that is dividing two levels. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to come here and I'm going to rename both my floor and my ceiling. So I'm going to rename my floor, and you can do that by double-clicking in it. And instead of 3D floor, I'm going to call it 3D first level, and then I'm going to double click on my ceiling and I'm going to rename this guy second level. Okay, so now what I can do is start by fixing some inaccuracies within my model. So you can see here that I actually made a mistake. Like, my floor here was supposed to go a little bit beyond because we have a wall coming here. So for this, you can go to my basic edits video. But basically, remember, just because geometry has been created in group does not mean that you cannot change it in any way, shape, or form. All you need to do is click, click, click until you see raw geometry. So click, 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 click. Now I can see raw geometry. I cannot see the rest of my model because I have turned on hide rest of model. If you want to be able to see the rest of your model, remember, you're going to go to view, you're going to go component edit, and turn off hide rest of model. And now I can use my push pull tool, P for push pull, to push pull this edge of my slab here. Remember, the push pull tool is a tool to generate geometry, but it can also be a tool to edit geometry. So same thing, I'm going to go here and push pull this guy here, push pull that guy there. Now be very careful. Remember, you want to have a clean model. This line shouldn't be here. So I'm going to select it and delete it. Beautiful. Awesome. So now what's going to happen is that I'm going to start modeling, and this is another place where you can basically decide how you want to tackle things. So by that, I mean basically what's going to happen with my walls and my columns, because there's two ways that I can do this. Option one, I could decide that I want all of my walls to be walls and I want all of my columns to be columns. Or I could say that I want to have first level walls, first level columns, second level walls, second level column. This is entirely up to you. In this case, I am going to be creating tags for my first level walls and columns and tags for my second level walls and columns. So I already have the first level, so all I'm going to do is rename them. So this is going to be first, and this is going to be, whoops, and this is going to be first. There you go. And now I can start modeling. Again, when you rename a tag, automatically updates with the geometry. So now I can start modeling my second level. Now, I'm a huge defender of the work smart, not hard. And basically the reason that I'm saying that is because if you stop and think about it for a second, the columns are the same in the first and second level because that's how columns work. So all I need to do is select my level 1 columns, form move, pick them up, Control to make a copy, up arrow key so they are locked in the vertical direction, and bring them there. And that's it, columns are done. Woof woof, that was easy. So all I need to do here is assign a different tag to them, because remember, because they are a copy, both of them are first level columns. So all I really need to do here is create a new tag, which is gonna be 3D second columns. And I'm gonna select these guys and say, you guys are gonna be my second columns. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Now you might need your reference for the wall heights and column heights and window heights. So in AutoCAD, I have here the reference for my second level, the same way that I had it when I was building my first level. And as you can see, same as before, we have our dimensions in millimeters. Once again, this is telling me that the plenum is 300, aka my roof, aka my whatever you want to call it. So just make sure that you have access to the actual dimensions in that reference. But I can see here that the ceiling height is the same. So again, if you want to verify this information, right now my model is set up for Imperial, but what I can do is go to Window, Model Info, Units, and I can switch to Decimal. In this case, I'm going to make it millimeters. And if I go here and I check 2500, perfect. I don't need to change the dimensions. I'm gonna go back to architectural and I'm gonna draw my walls. So I'm gonna turn off my columns because they're in the way. Remember, I'm following exactly the same rules that I did when I was building my first level. So that means that I only model one thing at a time. I ignore everything else. When I'm modeling that thing, I create a group for it. And now the only thing that I'm gonna do different is that I will immediately also assign a tag to it, because we already know that tags exist. So what I'm gonna be doing here is I'm going to speed up through this process because it's exactly the same, and I will get back to you when I am done modeling my second level because it's the same as the first level. So I'll see you in a bit. I've created my walls, I've made my openings using my references. As I said before, the process here is really the same. The only things that are really changing is that your reference is starting higher than your previous reference, and the fact that you're going to be naming your tags differently, accounting for the fact that now you have different levels with different purposes. So you don't necessarily have a top or bottom floor slash ceiling. Instead, you have first level, second level, and my roof. A couple things that I want to bring up. Number one, the one thing that I do like about this method is that it might help you notice certain mistakes that you may have when you're connecting levels. So for example, and spoilers, because we're going to talk about that later when it comes to more advanced modeling, I need stairs. Right now, you kind of need to fly to go from one level to the other, and you have to like exit the building and then come in through a window. So I need to account an opening in my slab to connect the first floor and the second floor. I'm not going to be doing that right now because, again, I'm going to be modeling my stairs later and I will tackle that problem at that point. But the one that I can tackle right now is the fact that this curtain wall is supposed to go from level one all the way to level two. It's not supposed to stop. And we have here a slab that is getting in the way. So what I can do here is I can go into this raw geometry and I can use my line command to create a little break and use my push-pull to push this slab a little bit far back, so that way I can leave an allowance of space for my curtain wall to go through both of these levels. But otherwise, you can repeat this exercise as many times as you want. Another thing that you can do if you want to is you can create groups within groups to help you manage the information. So by that I mean that, for example, right now, if let's say I want to work only on the first level, look at all the things that I would have to turn off. I have to turn off the roof, I have to turn off the 2D wall, the second floor walls, I have to turn off the second wall columns and the second level walls. I'm also going to turn off my references just because, and now I can work on this space. So that is not very convenient. So I have a couple of options to manage this. One is what we already discussed in the tags video, which is that I could create a tags folder. So for example, I could select all of the elements that have the second in them, and I could create a folder here that is just going to be called 3D second. And what that is going to do is basically create a folder that is going to contain all of my second level geometry. So if I want to quickly hide it, all I need to do is turn this off. I'm leaving my roof out because I would usually not consider the roof a part of the geometry. And then I can do the same thing with my first level. I can select all of the elements in that first level and create another folder that is going to be 3D first. And then just put all of that information there so I can basically turn all of those elements off. The other option that I could do is I could use grouping to basically gather all of this first and second level information together. So remember, you can have groups within groups. So I could, for example, select my first level slab, my first level columns, and my first level walls, right click and make all of that into a single group. And then I can create a new tag for that group, which is going to be my 3D first. And all I need to do is assign that tag, and now I can just turn all of the elements within that tag on and off. I'm going to do the same thing for my second level. So I'm going to select all of the elements in my second level, as well as the slab. I'm going to group them, and I'm going to create another tag called 3D second. And once again, I'm going to assign that tag to it. So really, this is up to personal preference. There is no right or wrong way to do this. As long as you are somehow classifying and managing your information, it doesn't really matter how you do that. You just need to have a system. Other things that I want to mention about this model, just because I can imagine that there's probably at least one architect in the comments having a stroke, and that is that this is not very architecturally accurate. So basically, if there would be a basement here, I would need to build that infrastructure. If there's no basement here, this is not good enough as a structural foundation slab. Also, if this is actually my roof, it should not be like this. Either my walls should go beyond a little bit so that way we can, you know, gather the water, or my roof should be projected. But what I will say to that is that this is a model that is intended for interior design uses only. I'm not going to be creating a facade elevation. I'm not going to be working with the outside. Everything will happen on the inside, so I will ignore the outside, okay? So don't hate me. I'm doing this on purpose just for the interior designers. Oh, there's one more little mistake here. This ceiling is supposed to stop there. There we go. All right. And with that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope you found that helpful. If you did, please give it a like, maybe a share. If you have any questions, by all means, feel free to add them in the comments. But otherwise, thank you very much for joining in. Thank you very much for sticking through. And I will see you on the next one. Have a good one. Bye.